Water is one of our planet's most important natural resources. In fact, it's a resource we literally can't live without. How much do you really know about water? Did you know there's as much water on the Earth now as there was when the Earth was formed? There will never be any more or any less? Did you know that 97% of that water supply is salt water in the oceans and unusable for our daily needs? That another 2% is frozen in ice caps and glaciers? So that leaves just 1% of the planet's entire water supply, our rivers, lakes, and groundwater, to meet everyone's water needs. Here's the catch. Many of those rivers, lakes, and groundwater sources are impaired, endangered by pollutants. That's right, this limited resource we all use day in and day out is in serious jeopardy. From plain old dirt to toxic chemicals, pollutants in our waterways are threatening our health and the health of the environment. So, how are these pollutants getting into our waterways and what can we do about it? That's the complicated puzzle we'll explore more today. Solving the water quality puzzle is an enormous challenge, simply because there are so many pieces to consider. The ways we use water, the practices that threaten it, the different pollutants in the water, and the sources of those pollutants, and hydrology, the water cycle, and ways we've interfered with it. Complicating the puzzle even more, these pieces never combine in exactly the same way. Every community's water quality problems are unique and depend entirely on which pieces are in play. Simply understanding the role each piece plays isn't enough. To solve problems, you have to understand the fit between the pieces, their relationship to one another. The way they're at work within your community create your specific water problems. Ready to dive in?